Ever feel like someone else is in control, like your body's not your own? That's the chilling reality of possession, and Hollywood has been capitalizing on that fear for decades. Today, we're diving headfirst into the realm of the possessed. Get ready to grip your seats as we count down the top five possession movies that have left us questioning our sanity, clutching our crosses, and sleeping with the lights on. So join me for this episode of Ranking Rumble. It's no secret that I'm not a huge fan of possession movies. They just don't do it for me. But I do recognize their importance in horror, and just because I don't gravitate towards them doesn't mean I don't like any of them. My biggest issue with this subgenre is that most of these movies feel the same to me. They're repetitive, predictable, and sometimes boring. On occasion, I will watch one and be intrigued by it and enjoy it quite a bit. And those are the movies that I'll be talking about today. And I'll go ahead and warn you. My list is going to be a little different, maybe even controversial, but it's just my opinion. If you disagree, just let me know which movies are your favorite down in the comments. But on that note, grab your popcorn and make your way to your seat. Let's head down to the ring. Coming in at number 5 is The Unholy, released in 2021. In the eerie quiet of rural Banfield, Massachusetts, a young deaf girl named Alice experiences a life-altering encounter. After a supposed visitation from the Virgin Mary, Alice is miraculously able to hear and speak, and even exhibits the power to heal others. News of Alice's newfound ability spreads rapidly, turning the small town into a pilgrimage site for believers seeking miracles.
How many are gonna watch? Mary wants to reach as many people as possible.
Maybe millions.
Jerry Finn, a disgraced journalist desperate for a career revival, sees Alice's story as his ticket back into relevance. Initially skeptical, he travels to Banfield to investigate, hoping to expose a hoax. However, as he witnesses Alice seemingly perform extraordinary feats, his skepticism wavers, replaced by a growing sense of unease. He begins to experience disturbing visions and uncovers a dark history that suggests a sinister force is at play, masquerading as the divine. Partnering with local priest Father Hagen and a skeptical doctor, Jerry races against time to uncover the truth behind Alice's miracles. Their investigation leads them to the haunting discovery of a malevolent entity and ancient evil disguised as the Virgin Mary seeking to exploit Alice's powers for its own nefarious purposes. The trio must confront this demonic presence, risking their lives to protect Alice and the unsuspecting townspeople from a terrifying fate. As the lines between faith and fear blur, they must rely on their wits, courage, and just the slightest glimmer of hope to vanquish the darkness and restore peace to Banfield. The biggest thing I like about this movie is Jeffrey Dean Morgan. He does such a good job with roles like this, even if I will always see him as John Winchester. I also like William Sadler as Father Hagen. The story here is different. It's not your typical person gets possessed and they bring in someone to help with the situation. There are some stakes. There's an investigation into why everything is happening. It makes for an interesting and a fun watch, even though this movie has been mostly forgotten. Hey, I said this list might be controversial. By the way, don't forget to body slam that subscribe button so you never miss any of the heart-pounding, chill-inducing 5-star matches we have here at WWH. We're not just wrestling with horror, we're delivering it to your screen every week. Coming in at number 4 is Deliver Us From Evil, released in 2014. In the heart of New York City, NYPD Sergeant Ralph Sarchi, a hardened cop with a troubled past, real original, I know, he finds himself grappling with a series of bizarre and violent crimes, void of any rational explanation. As a man of faith who has become disillusioned by the darkness he encounters on the streets, Ralph is initially hesitant to accept the possibility of a supernatural explanation. However, as the incidents escalate in their brutality and strangeness, he begins to question his own beliefs. The turning point comes when Ralph crosses paths with Father Mendoza, an unconventional priest with a deep understanding of the demonic realm. Mendoza, having witnessed firsthand the malevolent forces at play, recognizes the signs of demonic possession in the victims of recent crimes. Reluctantly, Ralph joins forces with Mendoza with a shared goal of uncovering the truth and protecting the innocent from the encroaching darkness. Their investigation leads them down a chilling path, revealing a sinister conspiracy involving a group of possessed individuals linked by their time in Iraq. The malevolent entity at the center of this conspiracy, a powerful demon known as Santino, seeks to unleash chaos and destruction upon the city. Ralph and Mendoza must race to decipher the demon's plans and overcome its destructive agenda. As the threat escalates, Ralph's own family becomes a target, forcing him to confront his personal demons and the darkness that lingers within. With his faith tested and his loved ones in danger, Ralph must make a choice between succumbing to despair or embracing the power of good. In a final showdown, Ralph and Mendoza must rely on their combined strength, courage, and faith to vanquish the demonic forces and restore peace to the city they call home. I get that a lot of this movie is very similar to other movies, but I really like the police procedural aspect of it. It just works for me. And I like Eric Bana in his role. Next up at number 3 is The Last Exorcism, released in 2010. Cotton Marcus is a preacher who's starting to doubt his own sermons. He's done a ton of exorcisms, but deep down he knows it's all just a show to mess with people and make a quick buck. Feeling guilty about it, he decides to film his last exorcism to show everyone how fake it all is. With a camera crew following him around, Cotton heads to a farm in the middle of nowhere to help out Nell, a young woman everyone thinks is possessed. At first, Cotton goes through the motions, using his usual tricks to make it look like he's got serious power. But things started getting weird, way weirder than his usual act. Nell starts acting seriously creepy, and the film crew sees things they can't explain. Cotton, who's always been good at fooling people, starts to wonder if he's accidentally stirred up something really bad. Things go downhill fast. The whole thing turns into a real nightmare, and the film crew gets caught up in all of it. The old farmhouse gets filled with fear, and whatever's lurking in the shadows seems to be getting stronger. Cotton's past lives catch up with him, and he's got to find a way to protect everyone, even though he's not sure what he believes in anymore. In the end, it's a fight against something they can't really see, and the cameras capture every terrifying moment of it. We find out what's really going on with Nell, and it makes everyone question what's real, what's in their heads, and if demons actually exist. The movie ends with a big twist, too, that will leave you with chills and wondering what's really out there in the dark. If you saw my video about movies that actually scared me, which I will link here, you know this movie was on that list, and that's why it's on this list as well. Plus, I actually like the use of found footage here quite a bit. Number 2 in this ranking rumble is The Possession, released in 2012. On the surface, this movie is pretty typical. It's about this totally normal family who gets thrown into a crazy situation because of this old box they find. The youngest daughter, Em, gets her hands on this weird box at a yard sale, and at first, it's like no big deal, just a kid with a new toy, right? Well, wrong. Things start getting really creepy really fast. Em starts acting all strange and out of it, totally freaking her parents out, even if her mom blames her dad for it all at first. It's like she's been taken over by something dark and evil, and it's seriously messing with her. The whole happy family vibe is completely gone at this point, and it's all tension and fear in the houses now. Turns out this isn't just any old box, it's a Dybbuk box, which is basically a container for a really evil spirit. The parents realize what's going on and go on this desperate mission to save their daughter from this thing that's trying to take her over. They end up getting help from a rabbi who knows a thing or two about exorcisms, and things get even wilder from there. It's a whole battle between good and evil, with the family fighting tooth and nail to save Em. The Possession is a movie that'll make you think twice about buying weird stuff at a yard sale. It's a good reminder that sometimes the most ordinary looking things can be hiding some seriously dark secrets. And yeah, this is another movie that stars Jeffrey Dean Morgan. He gives a strong performance, and alongside him is Kira Sedgwick playing his ex-wife who holds a lot of resentment towards him. And look, I get that this movie is just a copy and paste from a lot of other movies, but for whatever reason, this movie has always stuck out to me. I think it's well written, well acted, and well directed. It's okay if you disagree, but that's my opinion. All right, we're coming up on our final entrant, but first let's take a quick break. We'll be right back with more WWH action. Be sure to check out some of the links down in the description if you are interested in any Redcon 1 products. There's a code that you can use to save 20%. And also, there's a link down there for my Pro Wrestling Tees store where you can get some of my merchandise. And also, if you're interested in supporting the channel in any way, there is a link to my Patreon in the description as well. So go join the WWH Universe, and we would love to have you. Our final entrant in this ranking rumble is The Exorcist, released in 1973. Of course, how could I not put The Exorcist at number 1? I mean, it's the movie that all of these other movies are trying to replicate. In Georgetown, Washington, D.C., a young girl named Reagan starts displaying increasingly disturbing behavior. Her concerned mother, Chris, seeks medical help but finds no answers. As Reagan's condition worsens, exhibiting violent outbursts and speaking in tongues, Chris turns to a local priest, Father Karras, who suspects demonic possession. With the approval of the church, Father Karras enlists the help of the experienced exorcist, Father Marin. Together, they embark on a harrowing battle against the ancient evil that has taken hold of Reagan's body and soul. The priests face unimaginable horrors and confront their own personal demons as they fight to save Reagan from the clutches of evil. What makes this movie so messed up is how it taps into our deepest fears of the unknown. You watch this innocent girl, Reagan, turn into something absolutely horrifying, and it makes you think about the darkness that could be lurking right under our noses every day. The movie's crazy special effects and disturbing themes push the limits of what people were used to seeing in movies back then. So it was a wild ride that left people freaked out and totally hooked. The Exorcist isn't just about scaring people, though. Director William Friedkin was super meticulous with every single detail, creating this super creepy atmosphere that just oozes out of every scene. There are iconic moments like Reagan spinning her head around and puking everywhere that they're forever burned into the brains of horror fans.
You know what she did?
The acting in this movie is also on another level. Linda Blair, the girl who played Reagan, is just amazing. She goes from this sweet kid to this vessel of pure evil, and it's both terrifying and really, really sad. Ellen Burstyn, who plays Reagan's mom, is also incredible. You can feel her desperation and helplessness as she watches her daughter go through this nightmare. And the priests, played by Max von Sydow and Jason Miller, are so real and relatable as their faith is tested. Even after all these years, The Exorcist is still talked about and referenced all the time. It started a whole wave of possession movies, but none of them have even come close to the original. It's one of those movies that sticks with you, and it's still analyzed, debated, and mentioned in all sorts of media. So yeah, The Exorcist isn't just a horror movie, it's a cultural icon that has seriously stood the test of time. It shocks, disturbs, and makes you think, and that's why it's still the best possession movie ever made. But there you have it. Those are my top 5 possession movies of all time. I don't expect you to agree with me completely, so just put your list down in the comments and don't forget to check out the links in the description. Also, if you enjoyed this look at some possessed movies, be sure to like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the channel so you never miss any of the action here at WWH. And remember, in the squared circle of horror, there are no countouts for nightmares. My name is Andrew Dreamer, and this is Wrestling with Horror.